asking the basic question, how can new knowledge serve society?
The bank as an institution made the decision 2-3 years ago that its knowledge and data are global public goods.
Libraries are at the heart of what we do as scholarly publishers, and we therefore need to embrace this changing landscape.
This conference for me has been incredibly important because I get to meet a number of peers and we can exchange ideas and learn from each other in terms of what is working and what isn't working with respect to access to the research literature in the developing world.
It's a really good opportunity to learn from each other, hear what other organizations are doing, and get new ideas.
Publishers for Development is actually incredibly important for us. It's again about disseminating information and building collaboration between one research group and others in a wider community.
You cannot have development without research. So it's very important that the research and the results are published by the publishers and it is well circulated.
Local research is coming up with local solutions to their issues, can steer development. So I think that's why research is important, and especially that it's done by the societies themselves.
Universities can champion their contributions publishing the research that goes on, and they can also serve as advocates or advisors to policymakers in the country, which can also help.
Engaged scholarship lies at the heart of any healthy society.
It's to try and get away from the perception that research uptake is a final add-on.
I know this is what he or she wants, this is what this organization wants, these are their priorities. So when I'm advocating, I go around that, make sure I fit in.
The metrics that I might want to use looking at publishing a journal based in the UK, how does this relate to a journal published in South Africa, in Tanzania, in Bangladesh?
These titles are under more pressure than ever in the increasingly globalised and increasingly open access world. We were kind of surprised, given the challenges that people are facing in publishing on the continent, what a strong sense of overall optimism there was nonetheless about the future of publishing in Africa.